Hey, what's up, my beautiful people? So in today's video, I want to talk about three cultural rules I broke while I was in Japan. And you know, they were not rules that I broke on purpose. It's just something that I, like, you know, as a foreigner, a new foreigner in Japan, I didn't know about. And after I broke those cultural rules, my Japanese friends told me about, like, later on, like, hey, you're not supposed to do that or whatever. And then I learned after that, like, okay, I'm not supposed to do this kind of stuff. You know, you just kind of learn as you go, you know, mistakes. You learn from your mistakes pretty much. So the first one is punctuality. Now, I want you guys to know that, yes, I'm from America, but I was raised in Mexican culture. My upcomings with my family, everything was Mexican, Mexican traditions, Mexican culture, everything Mexican, right? Now, one thing about Mexicans, if you're a Mexican yourself or you know a Mexican, is that us Mexicans, we like to be fashionably late to things. Now, you know, if there's like a party or a meeting or anything, you know, Mexicans tend to be late. You know, we like to be fashionably late. Why? Because if you're there on time, it's kind of like a little bit too early. You get there on time, you're too early. So let me give you an example. Let's say that my Mexican aunt is having like a get together, a baby, I don't know, like my niece's party or whatever. They're having a party and they tell me like, yo, Kiko, be here at 5. The party starts at 5. My ass is not gonna be there at 5. If I get there at 5, they're still gonna be getting the food ready. They're still gonna be getting everything ready. Like, why am I gonna get there at 5, you know? And I'm just gonna show up and they're still getting everything ready. No, I'm gonna show up at 6. If they say be there at 5, I'm showing up at 6 or 7. You know, I'm gonna be late because that's like when everything starts up, party starts up, people start arriving at that time, and that's when the party starts going. So they tell you be there at 5, it actually means be here like around 6 or 7. But if you want to be super early, then be here at 5. That's what that means. Being raised in a Mexican family, man, I learned that real quick. You know, like, I used to work at my uncle and aunt's business, and they would always tell me like, yo, Kiko, come help us out at our business until like 5 o'clock 5 p.m. and my aunt would always tell me like, yo, I know you've been working all day, I'll be there at 6. She doesn't show up until like 8. So I learned that real quick. Like, all right, when they say they're gonna be here, like when Mexicans say that they're gonna do something at a certain time, they actually mean like an hour or 2 hours later. In America, it seems like in American culture, you know, if an event happens at 5, Americans tend to be there like on time, like right at 5 or like a couple minutes before 5, or maybe a little bit after 5. Now in Japan specifically, if there is an event or something going on and people invite you, let's say like they're like a Japanese person or like a Japanese group is having an event like around, let's say 7 o'clock, right? If they say 7 o'clock, you should actually get there like around 6 or 6:30, not 7, because if you arrive at 7, you are way too late. So you're supposed to arrive there like an hour early, like half an hour early, because if you arrive like right at 7, even though the event starts at 7, you're way too late. It's like, dude, like, why are you getting here so late? So Japan is kind of like the opposite of like Mexican culture. So let's give like another example. All right, let's say like there's like a big event or like a group meeting going on, and it starts like, yeah, like let's say 5, you know, it starts at 5. Japanese people are gonna get there like at 4 or 4:30. Americans are gonna be there like right at 5 or a little bit before or after 5. Mexicans are gonna be there like an hour later or 2 hours later, all right? So, you know, we got a different dynamic going on here. And you can kind of see like where the conflict comes in, you know? Like, all right, we got this Kiko guy. The event starts at 5. He should be arriving at 4. Why is he arriving at 6? Yo, like, that's like way too late. Like, come on, guy, where you been? You know, did you get lost? That happened to me a lot, man. Like, my university will always have like these events, and you know, they would tell me like the time it starts at. And after the event starts, like, I start getting messages from my friends and my teachers like, yo, where you at? You know, like, why aren't you here yet? Or like, we're getting a little bit worried, you know, did you get lost or something? In my mind, I'm like, yo, like, the event hasn't even started. Like, we still have like 5 minutes till the event. You know, the event starts at 5, it's 4:55. Why are you guys like telling me, like, worrying about me? You know, like, the event hasn't even started yet. And but then I kind of understood, like, hey, you should be getting there a little bit early, not later. The first cultural rule I broke was being late. And I'm not talking about like Japanese late, but I'm talking about being Mexican late, which is like an hour or two after the event already started, which I did a couple of times. I learned really quick, like, I should try and get there early. So after I learned about that rule, I started arriving like 10 minutes or 15 minutes early, which is still kind of late, I guess, in their eyes. So anyway, that's one rule I broke, something I had to get used to. But punctuality, which means arriving on time, or in Japanese words, arriving early, is very important in Japan. Punctuality, be there early, do not be there on time, and do not be there after the event has technically already started. So there's one rule I broke. The second rule I broke is a pretty simple one. I already made a video about this. If you guys want to watch the video, the story I made about this rule, I'll link it in the description. So anyway, one day there was an event in my city, and one of the members of the royal family of Japan, I think she was like the niece of the emperor, and that still makes her a princess. Well, anyway, she was like one of the hosts of the event. And after the event, we all got split up into groups where we like discussed world issues. And the princess, she was going around around, you know, talking to certain groups and sitting at certain groups' tables. There was a lot of tables, and she was only like going to a couple of tables. She was doing it for like, I guess, like the pictures and stuff. And of course, she was surrounded by like a million bodyguards. I don't know how I got lucky, but she chose my table to come and sit at. And she sat down and talked with like the group in my table. And you know, the group in my table, they were all Japanese. And the moment she sat down, all of them like put their head down and like they all got like super shy. Like we were talking, you know, eye contact, but the moment she sat down, everybody went like this, like got really, really shy. And my dumbass, you know, because I'm a dumbass, I knew she was the princess and everything, but like I'm like, you know what, I'm just gonna try and keep it cool. I'm not gonna get shy. I'm gonna treat her like a friend, like a person, right? So I looked at her and I'm like, hi Akiko-san, my name is Kiko. And you know, she looked at me, she's like, oh, your name is Kiko, because you know, our names like sound the same, they sound like similar. Yeah, and after the event, like after talking with her for a while, I told one of my Japanese friends, like, oh yeah, like one of the members of the royal family came and sat down at my table, told her like, you know, hey, how's it going Akiko-san, blah blah blah. I told him the story. If you guys want to see the full story, again, I'll link it in the description. I already made a video about this, but anyway, my Japanese friend said like, Kiko, did you really call her Akiko-san, S-A-N, san, which is, you know, kind of like, I guess, a respectful way of addressing someone? And I said, yes, I did. And I said, san, using san, S-A-N, to address someone, like, yeah, that's respectful, but that's respectful for like just a general respect. And general respect is okay for like common people, but when you're addressing like royalty, you're supposed to say sama, and sama is like the utmost, highest respect of addressing someone. So if you're using the basic respect against a member of the royalty family, it could actually come off as being disrespectful, because you're using like the basic respect and not the utmost respect. So that was one cultural rule I broke right there, is addressing a member of the royal family as san and not sama. So there's one right there for you guys. All right, the third one. Your third one is a basic one, pretty much. You know, here in America, like throughout high school, throughout college, when I meet friends, specifically female friends, when I greet them or say bye to them, I usually give them like a quick hug or whatever. If I'm not gonna see them for a long time, you know, I'll be like a longer hug, you know, just a friendly hug. You guys know what a friendly hug is. Not like a romantic hug, just a friendly hug. Female family members, it's also like a quick hug. You know, it's just something I used to, you know, give a hug, a quick hug, as a greeting and a goodbye. Especially if you're not gonna see someone for a long time, then it's more like a bigger hug. Anyway, in Japan, I always had this ingrained in my head, you know, like that's normal to do. So when I first arrived in Japan, you know, I started meeting friends. I started meeting, you know, female friends, female Japanese friends. And after we became like, you know, I guess not really close friends, but good friends, we would hang out. And then I'll be like, you know, I'll do the normal thing. Like, all right, it was fun hanging out with you guys. I'll talk to you guys later. You know, have a good night. And going for the quick hug, you know. I didn't realize it at first, but I learned really quick that you shouldn't be doing that, like hugging Japanese girls, even if they are just your friends, you shouldn't be like going around like hugging them, because that is something only boyfriends and girlfriends do. And if you do it to like a Japanese girl, like out of nowhere, like what I was doing, it's gonna make them very, very uncomfortable. And you know, they're very respectful, they're not gonna say anything, you know, they're gonna let you do it, and they're probably not gonna show it on their face, but it's gonna make them very uncomfortable. So don't do that. If you meet some female friends in Japan, you know, don't hug them. It's gonna make them feel uncomfortable, and avoid that. It took me a while to learn that, but eventually my friends did tell me like, hey, you know, like hugging should only be for like boyfriends or girlfriends. It is acceptable, I guess, if like you're not gonna see somebody for a long time. For example, like when I was coming back to America and I was saying goodbye to all my friends, then yeah, hugging is acceptable. Like, hey, I'm not gonna see you for a long time, all right, a quick hug, you know, that's cool, acceptable. But if you're just doing it like normally, like I'm not gonna see you in a week, hug, then yeah, don't do that. Only for boyfriends and girlfriends. And yeah, if you do it, you're gonna make someone very uncomfortable. But yeah, those were three cultural rules that I broke while I was in Japan. But like I said, you know, I didn't know about them, and I did learn really quick. You know, you learn from your mistakes. And you know, my Japanese friends did teach me like, hey, what you should do and what you shouldn't do. So yeah, if you enjoyed this video and you want to see more videos like this, you know, let me know, drop a like, drop a comment, subscribe if you like this kind of content. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one, right? Peace out.